So, what is a test cross and why is it used in biology? If I handed you a black guinea pig and asked, "What's the phenotype of this guinea pig for fur color?" You would gently hold the guinea pig and you would look at it and you would say, "It's black, you dummy. All you got to do is look at it." And I would say, "Correct, and please don't call me dummy." If I handed you the same guinea pig and asked, "What's the genotype of this guinea pig with respect to its fur color?" Well, you wouldn't be able to tell me, and I wouldn't be able to tell you either. The reason is we don't know because there are two genotypes that could be for this guinea pig. We could have the homozygous dominant genotype, capital B, capital B, or the heterozygous genotype, capital B, lowercase b. And we can't actually see the alleles without serious scientific chromosomal type analysis. And that's assuming that a guinea pig genome project has been completed for us to refer to. And I don't think it has. So how do we figure this out? We perform a test cross. What is that? The test cross is the cross of an organism with an unknown dominant genotype with an organism that is homozygous recessive for that trait. What does it do? A test cross determines whether the individual being tested is homozygous dominant or purebred or heterozygous dominant or hybrid. So here's an example. Here's our black guinea pig. Black is the dominant color in guinea pigs for fur. We don't know if the genotype is heterozygous or homozygous dominant. We would take this guinea pig and we would mate it with a female guinea pig that has the homozygous recessive trait. So in guinea pigs, this would be a white guinea pig. Okay? So we would give them a little privacy, hope the female becomes pregnant, and wait for the baby guinea pigs to be born, and then we would look at the offspring from this cross. So let's do this on a Punnett square. When you're doing a test cross Punnett square, you always use two Punnett squares. You do two crosses. Cross one, take the homozygous dominant for the trait, in this case, capital B, capital B, cross it with the homozygous recessive for the trait. So what would this look like? We have our black guinea pig, possibility of homozygous dominant, cross with the white guinea pig, which is recessive. Offspring, 100% from this cross would be black or heterozygous for the black trait. Cross two, you're going to take the heterozygous possibility of the guinea pig and cross it with the homozygous recessive white guinea pig again. Okay, you're always crossing with the homozygous recessive. So in this case, there's 50% chance that the offspring would be black, 50% chance that the offspring would be white. So then how does this correspond with the real life mating of our guinea pigs? When the guinea pig babies are born, you look at them, and if any of the offspring from the test cross have the recessive trait, in this case, if they were white, then the genotype of the parent with the dominant trait must be heterozygous. Okay? So just a few key points to remember about a test cross. The organism with the dominant trait is always crossed with an organism with a recessive trait. In our guinea pigs, we cross the dominant trait of black with the recessive fur color trait of white. If any offspring show the recessive trait, the unknown genotype is heterozygous for the trait. If all the offspring have the dominant trait, the unknown genotype is homozygous dominant. Large numbers of offspring are needed for reliable results. That's it for test cross. Thank you for listening.